floor, I take their ransom. I know that I'm gone. They see me blowing up, now they say they want some. I got two twins, turn you to a dancer. I see two twins. Yo, 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 what's good? It's your boy T-Storms the Trucker. Checking in with y'all, let y'all know what's going on. So let me start by introducing myself. You can call me T-Storms, T-Storms the Trucker. But I just want to let y'all know, man, I just got my license, I don't know, 2-3 weeks ago. Just got my CDL license about 2-3 weeks ago. And as soon as I got my license, I got job offers. I probably had 3 job offers. There's a couple OTR, a couple local. And, you know, as a new driver, you can get a local job. You don't have to just do OTR if you don't want to. If you want to do OTR, then do it. You know what I mean? But don't think that that's all you have. That's the only option that you have, because it's not. So, it's really not, man. It's not the only option that you have at all. And how I got my offer was, I pretty much built a resume. I had a resume, and I used that as a tool to kind of introduce myself. You know, whatever, the normal stuff you put in your introduction, you know, your work ethic, blah, blah. You don't have that much experience, obviously, if you just got your license. You don't have any experience. But you do have experience in things that they're looking for, whether you worked in a warehouse, whether you're good at customer service, whether you delivered stuff before, whether you drove a non-CDL truck, whatever you did, you know what I mean? That relates to driving, because it's not just driving that these places are looking for. So what I do now is I'm in LTL, and because I never drove a forklift, I had to do a week of training on the dock. That experience was, what's the right word, man? It was interesting, because dock, I don't know if you've ever seen a dock before, especially for a busy company, like a busy logistics company, but it's crazy. It's about, they probably got about 30 forklifts. And these guys, I mean, they're flying up and down the floor. It's just crazy. So I had to do that for a week. It wasn't that bad. I pretty much got it. I was by myself the second day. The guy that I was with, I want to say I'm not sure if he's by himself yet. He might be. I'm not really sure, but he does have experience driving forklifts. And he's actually a dock worker, so. But yeah, so when you first start, if you don't have any forklift experience, they'll train you if you make it past the interview. You know what I'm saying? If you make it past the interview, they don't have no problem training you. That's one thing about this company. They don't really have a problem training, you know, if they like you, they'll work with you pretty much. You give them a good impression, they'll work with you. Like I said, I'm a fast learner, and that was one of the things I did put in my resume. So I wanted to make sure that I did do it fast. Like, I didn't want to take long. But, and I didn't. I got it in a couple of days. So, and it's a physical job. So if you don't want to pull, push loads, get out, move bars in the truck, unstrap shit, probably not the job for you. I see a lot of people, a lot of complaints about the company, but I'm starting high 20s, you know what I mean? I'm getting paid high 20s, so I mean, I can't really complain about it yet, but it is physical. So that's just the first week so far that I've been there. They train me on the dock using the forklift, unloading trucks, loading trucks. And then next week, I'm going to be doing P&D starting Monday, which is tomorrow. So I got to be there at 8 a.m. to do my P&D training, which is pickup and delivery. So we'll see how that goes. I'm going to do that for 2 weeks. And then after I do my pickup and delivery, I'm going to go line haul for another 2 weeks. And then I believe my permanent position is going to be line haul. I'm not too sure. They might put me in P&D. Probably going to be line haul. I already get paid well in line haul, so I'm not really too concerned about that. But it's not that bad, man. It's a great company, great benefits, health insurance is really good. It's a really affordable. I want to say for me and my son, I pay like $50 for like top tier everything, life for everything. So you can't beat that. But that's all. I just wanted to let y'all know, man, what it is when you're a new driver, if you get hired on to one of these companies, such as XPO Logistics or YRC Freight or Old Dominion, what the first week is like in training. It's pretty easy. Everybody's pretty laid back, you know. So that's about it, man. Once I get done with the P&D, I'll come back in and check with y'all and let y'all know what's good with that. That should be interesting. So we'll see tomorrow, and then I'll probably check back in with you guys. Maybe I'll check in Friday when I get out, or maybe Saturday. I'm not sure yet. It depends. Maybe I'll check in with y'all tomorrow. I don't know yet. I want to see. I don't know. But I'll definitely let y'all know. So, man, if you're watching this video, like, subscribe. I'll put a link down in the comments to my, so you could either email me or you could hit me. You can follow me on Instagram and just write me in my DM. And let me know if you have any questions about my first week as far as not having no forklift experience and having to train on the dock for a week. Like, comment, subscribe, and again, just let me know if you guys have any questions. I'll try to keep you updated on what it takes to be a LTL driver and the process of a new driver and what I got to go through or what you're going to have to go through if you decide to come this route. Holla at your boy, man. Again, check my hit me in my DM. Send me an email if you have any questions. I'm out.